Welcome to the InfoWars Nightly News. So glad you can join us on this first day of October 2015. I'm your host, Jakari Jackson, and here's a look at our top stories.
Tonight, another gun-free zone left victims defenseless as a crazed gunman killed at least 13 people at a community college in Oregon. Then, a day after Russia launched an attack against ISIS in Syria, Iran begins to dispatch ground troops into the region to fight alongside the forces loyal to President Bashar al-Assad. Meanwhile, Russia says future airstrikes in Syria will be accompanied by ground advances by the Syrian army and its allies. And the InfoWars team launches a counter-protest in support of the Second Amendment at UT, where University of Texas police arrested protesters for exercising their First Amendment right.
Anywhere in this West
All that plus much more up next on the InfoWars Nightly News.
And it's that type of behavior that spurred me to do the research to develop a true nutraceutical formula that was designed to smooth out and help children focus. All of our children are hit with modern mind control. Television, music, fast food, GMOs, sugars, you name it. Young humans have not yet developed their nervous system and are being hammered daily by globalist concoctions. It's no wonder they can't focus and calm down and then are put on dangerous psychotropic drugs. Working with my team, we set out to find the best formula with the highest quality ingredients that children would actually like and take. We worked with the leading manufacturer in nutritional supplements that are safe for children to bring you the most affordable and powerful calming formula out there. Introducing Child Ease with herbs and calming extracts like chamomile and lemon balm and essential nutrients that taste great. Obtain your Child Ease today at InfoWarsLife.com. That's Child Ease exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com.
Today, we were greeted by the very unfortunate news of a shooting in Oregon. This was at UCC in Oregon, and reports continue to evolve, but as of right now, they're listing 13 killed, including the shooter, also 20 people injured, and as of right now, they're listing the shooter as a 20-year-old male. And as usual, you know, the bodies aren't even cold yet, and people are saying that we need to ban this, we need to ban that. But as Michael Cargill, you know, of Central Texas Gunworks, who is a friend of our show, he always says that you can't legislate crazy. That is the case here as well. You know, of course, our thoughts and prayers go out to the families affected. But the issue about it is whether you go back Old Testament and it's people killing each other with rocks and spears, or more modern times where people are killing each other with, you know, assault rifles or whatever it may be, even though we have an article about that we'll touch on a little bit later. People with ill intent have ill intent, and passing no matter of laws is going to stop that. Murder's been illegal for how many years now? People still murder each other. We see mothers drowning their children in bathtubs. We see all manner of things, people poisoning each other with arsenic. So it's a tool like anything else, referring to the firearm. It can be used for a good purpose, but they don't want to talk about the 12-year-old Oklahoma girls who shoot the home intruders when they're home alone. No, they just want to talk about things like this. They are very unfortunate, and of course, our thoughts and prayers go out to the people affected, and we'll see what happens in the coming days. And in other news, many of us have seen the very shocking videos that have come out about these Planned Parenthood facilities. People saying that they want to use the proceeds of dead baby parts to finance Lamborghinis. People who are medical professionals saying that they thought that the fetuses were supposed to be dead before they underwent the chopping up procedures, and all manner of other horrific things. And now we have the head of Planned Parenthood saying that questions about the aborted baby part sales are sexist. And representatives voted 241 to 185 for legislation that would see the organization defunded, while the investigation into the purported sale of aborted tissues and organs continues. The bill states, for the one-year period beginning on the date of the enacted of this division, no funds authorized or appropriated by the federal law may be used or made available for any purposes to Planned Parenthood Federation of America Incorporated. And it says, meanwhile, Planned Parenthood head Cicely Richards has complained that the questions put to her by the congressional panel this week are sexist. So it's sexist to ask questions about videos, which they say are edited. And of course the videos are edited. These are, you know, dinner conversations, lunch conversations that could be, you know, 2 hours long. They edit it down to the best, you know, 5 or so minutes, best 10 minutes. They do the same thing with presidential speeches. Obama speaks for an hour. They knock it down to 2 to 3 minutes to make it digestible for the populace. Is it out of context? You can debate that one way or another when you talk about the speech. But when we talk about these Planned Parenthood videos, I don't think they are out of context. This is just putting them in the proper context that they don't want to be viewed in. And, you know, we see so many people come out and defend Planned Parenthood, particularly when it comes to these videos. These are people who know that they're going to jail if these facts come out or if this turns out to be true. And I definitely believe that it is true. So, of course, they may get up there and bend the truth, if not all out lie. When it comes to bringing this information to the light, they don't want this information to touch the light of day. They don't want one, to defund their organization. They don't want two, to end up in a prison cell. So they're going to do anything that they have to in order to make sure that those situations do not come about. And now many people are involved or touching on these issues. And one such person who was questioned about this was one Nancy Pelosi. And she was stumped when she was asked about whether or not babies are human beings. And here's a look at her response.
Take your ideological questions. I don't have, look, you know, no, listen, I want to say something to you. I don't know who you are, and you're welcome to be here, Freedom of This Press. I am a devout, practicing Catholic, a mother of 5 children. When my baby was born, my 5th child, my oldest child, was 6 years old. I think I know more about this subject than you, with all due respect.
And it's very troubling to see one of our elected officials who cannot answer such a simple question as to whether or not these are human beings. So from the war in the womb to the all-out war, we now see Iranian troops to conduct ground attacks in Syria. Iran has dispatched hundreds of ground troops to Syria to fight alongside the forces loyal to President Assad. And it says Lebanese Hezbollah troops will also join the Iranian forces, the sources note, as well as Iraqis. And I believe this is coming out of Reuters. And Kurt Nimmo takes a similar look at this with his article, Iran, Hezbollah, Syrian Army Prepared to Launch Offensive Against CIA Proxies. And he notes, in May, the Al-Qaeda-aligned jihadist group that has pledged allegiance to the Islamic State al-Nusra captured the last Syrian government-held area in Idlib. So we all know that these guys are getting, as far as the Islamic State, they're getting airdrop grenades from Western governments. They're riding around in SUVs, the Humvees, the MRAPs, and all these type of things that have been left over by Western governments. And, you know, they're pretty much given free rein to run around, because we see people like John McCain saying that we have to fund these guys to shoot down the Russians just like they did, you know, years past. So it's a very troubling situation, because especially when you got a guy like McCain who kind of flip-flops, like, yeah, I was out there hanging out with these guys. I didn't know they were Al-Qaeda rebels. And people said, okay. And now he's saying, yeah, we got to go arm these guys to shoot down the Russians. And it just really doesn't make a whole lot of sense, in my opinion, the way these guys are going about it, talking about the big Western governments. But the things continue to rage out of control. And like I said, I'm not here cheerleading for Putin or for Assad. I'm not saying these guys are the greatest guys on earth, but they're not the ones who are funding people with these Al-Qaeda rebels, these ISIS rebels who are burning down Christian villages, chopping people's heads off, ripping people's hearts out, and doing all manner of horrible, horrific things over there in the Syrian area. So it's plenty of blame to go all the way around. And we began our show talking about Oregon. There is some more Oregon news coming up. And we see Oregon to begin as the 3rd state in the U.S. to allow recreational marijuana sales. It says Oregon residents 21 years and older can buy up to 1/4 ounce of dried flowers. Dried flowers is kind of funny that they put that in there. Roughly 200 existing medical use marijuana dispensaries. As a new law took effect, and that backers hope will help curb the flourishing black market. So as you guys have probably seen, I've seen as well, the gangster movies, the prohibition movies about guys riding around with their Tommy guns shooting out of windows because of alcohol prohibition. And it's such a romanticized type of thing when we look back on it in history, but that same thing is happening today, but it's not alcohol, it's drugs. So when people realize that this is one of the big reasons why we have such a huge black market for things, including marijuana, if people just realize that if we take off the tough sanctions we have on it, And not just to say that we need to have people legalize marijuana so we have people smoking in the streets. My biggest deal with the war on drugs, as far as marijuana is concerned, is we put people in jail, or in prison, rather, for mandatory minimums. So we got people going to jail, record numbers, actually releasing violent offenders to put in these, you know, weed smokers. But on top of that, we're funding a huge black market, or helping to fund a huge black market, by keeping these things illegal. Now, once again, I'm not advocating to anybody go out there and smoke marijuana just to smoke it, but I'm also not advocating that we have people locked up for, you know, small uses or just under mandatory minimums. It's completely absurd that you would let out a murderer or a rapist to put in some guy who got caught with a joint in his pocket when he got pulled over by the cops. It's completely ridiculous, but people will continue to push this. And it's so troubling to me that people will knock something like medical marijuana, moving from recreational to medical, they'll knock medical marijuana, but they'll go to, you know, Walgreens or CVS or whatever, and they'll get something that's even stronger in a prescription pill, something like Oxycontin, which I believe is synthetic heroin, and they think that's perfectly fine. You know, they'll have people high as a kite, you know, with their prescription pills, you know, they get in car wrecks or whatever else, they're addicted to this stuff, they actually have to go to some facility to get off of it, you have to go through some type of program to get off of it, but they demonize things like medical marijuana. And when you sit back and look at it, because I don't take any drugs, so I can look at it from a very far off view, I can look at this side over here, I can look at that side over there, and I say, okay, so you can get high off the illegal drugs just like you can get high off the prescription drugs, you can get addicted to the illegal drugs just like you can get addicted to the prescription drugs. What's the deal here? Well, it's not so much in terms of addiction when we talk about marijuana, but the pharmaceutical companies don't want you to be able to grow something in your backyard or in your basement that may put them out of business or at least knock a big hole in their profits. They don't want to do that. So therefore, they make things illegal so you can't use them as your personal benefit. Once again, not talking about recreational drugs, but medical drugs, because you can see people who have numerous health benefits from smoking marijuana. You know, like I said, it's not something on recreation. I'm pending recreation or advocating that you go out there and do for recreational purposes. But if you can have a medical benefit, why not do that in terms of things like marijuana? But I've lingered on that far enough, because we also have another story coming out of Oregon. And this is the family, you guys may recall, who was the owners of a bakery. And they got they got shut down, basically, because they would not bake a cake for a lesbian couple. Now, the bakers do want to stress the point that they have made cakes for homosexuals in the past. They just refused to make wedding cakes because they said, hey, we just don't believe that. And they do have a First Amendment right in the United States of America. That is their freedom of religion. But they're saying that the homosexual couple's rights trump their rights. So that's what the state said. And they ordered them to pay $135,000 to the same-sex couple because they were denied service. Once again, they didn't discriminate in terms of sexual orientation. They said, hey, we'll bake you any other cake. We'll bake you a graduation cake or a birthday cake or whatever else. They just said, because of our religious beliefs, we cannot provide you with the wedding cake that you desired. That was not enough for some people. And now they're offering, or now they're demanding, rather, that this bakery pay $135,000 to this same-sex couple. And this is even a different deal from the marriage license fiasco that has come about recently, because that was a state employee, and you can argue yes or no, she should have put out the marriage license. But this is a couple, they're privately owned, they don't get government funds, they're not paid by the government, they don't get a government paycheck. So at the end of the day, it should be their personal preference or their religious preference who they are able to provide wedding cakes to, but not everybody sees that way in the United States of America. Now, in our next segment, we're going to have a special report, or I guess pretty much my rant, about some things that happened today as far as the campus of the University of Texas, because Joe Biggs, Kit Daniels, and some of our other crew members went out there, and they were having a Moms Demand Action rally. And for anybody who's not familiar with the group, they are a Bloomberg-affiliated group, and they go out and pretty much try to take your Second Amendment rights away. And to anybody who says that's out of context, well, we've done multiple reports. I don't have the flyer on the desk right now. But they'll hand you a flyer. It says, we want to ban assault weapons. Meanwhile, they'll say, we don't want to take away your guns. You're like, well, you just handed me this piece of paper that has the official Moms Demand Action logo on it. It says you want to take away this certain type of gun. And now we have this article from Kit Daniels FBI nearly five times more murders committed with knives than assault rifles. Then he breaks down the FBI numbers, and you don't have to believe me, you don't have to believe Kit. You can go down to FBI.gov and see all these numbers for yourself. And he breaks down the facts and figures. And I'm going to jump to the end here, or at least the end of my printout. Overall, the number of murders involving guns has plunged from 8,855 in 2012 to 8,454 in 2013 and to now 8,124 in 2014. So you can see right there, you know, a lot of people think that gun murders have gone up, and I can understand why, because they're very sensationalized in the media. Because when you have somebody who, you know, gets bludgeoned with a hammer, or somebody who gets stabbed, you know, it's really more of a local news story. But if you have a story about a guy using a fully automatic rifle, which is, you know, very rare to see those type of murders here in the United States in the first place. But when those do happen, they get a ton of media coverage. So I can understand why people think, you know, there's some guy on every corner shooting off an AK-47. But also, again, these guys are looking for soft targets. Very rarely, they do happen, but very rarely will you see somebody go and pick a fight at a police station. Like it's happened here in the city of Austin, Texas. You know, the guy, I believe it was last year, last November, around Thanksgiving time, he goes up to the Austin police station, you know, shoots out the windows. The cop comes and responds. And of course, that didn't last too much longer after that. But by and large, these guys look for what you would call a soft target, a school or a church or someplace they anticipate people not being able to protect themselves. Case in point, what we saw up in Oregon and what we've seen in Columbine, Virginia Tech, and many other institutions. So now people are asking the question whether or not students should be able to carry a concealed handgun on the campus. And I say I have really no issue with that, because the majority of the people who came out to our demonstration who were against campus carry were kids who were too young to handle a firearm in the first place, at least in terms of a concealed handgun. So we'll have more on that when we come after this break. Stay tuned. This is the InfoWars Nightly News.
You traitors claiming I'm a Ruski agent, say it to my face and I'll break your nose. I'm sick of it. I will stomp your head in the ground, you traitorous maggots, while we go under Obamacare, North American Union, conquered by European banks, announcing our kids don't belong to us, total bondage, total surveillance, and you want to shoot your mouth off about me being a Ruski agent, I will stomp your head in the ground.
Never water yourself down just because someone can't handle you at 100 proof. It's the Alex Jones Show, because there's a war on for your mind.
I wish we could go back to the days, I'm telling you, of just getting my satisfaction out in the street. You pick a sword or something else.
Your liver can be full of fatty deposits, built-up toxins, and even dangerous objects known as liver stones. We worked with the top developers in the field of detox to take tried and true herbs and other compounds known to safely cleanse the liver and fused it with the latest research and technological development on concentrating these ingredients to give you the maximum effect. Liver Shield is the only liver support product on the market that uses a patented Spigerex blend of powerful organic herbs that support detoxification. And when you visit InfoWarsLife.com, see the instructional video on how to do a six-day liver detox. This isn't a game, and let me tell you, the results are dramatic. Liver Shield is totally organic and made of the safest high-quality herbs. But that said, you need to consult your physician before you do the full detox. Liver Shield can also be used daily by itself for overall upkeep of the liver. Secure your Liver Shield today exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com for the lowest price available. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139. Brain Force is here. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been on this the last few months. You probably noticed I've been more crazed, more focused, less brain fog, more energy, more special reports, and it's because of Brain Force.
One of the worst things with most energy products is it's not sustainable, right? You're gonna crash and gonna feel really bad afterwards. This has a bunch of different antioxidants and compounds and polyphenols.
Everybody's on these drugs to knock their brain out because the brain's so fried.
We kept changing this formula over and over and over again until it became sort of a grand puzzle. For example, the L-theanine inside of it, that is activated by the different compounds in the yerba mate that we put inside of it as well. This just increases the compounds you already have.
This is what you're actually designed to run on.
Exactly.
It's kind of like a car will run on one form of junkie gas, but it runs really good on what it's designed for.
You will find Brain Force, Survival Shield X2, and other game-changing products at InfoWarsLife.com. Or call 888-253-3139.
3139.
I want more candy. I want more video games. Why, why, why?
And it's that type of behavior that spurred me to do the research to develop a true nutraceutical formula that was designed to smooth out and help children focus. All of our children are hit with modern mind control. Television, music, fast food, GMOs, sugars, you name it. Young humans have not yet developed their nervous system and are being hammered daily by globalist concoctions. It's no wonder they can't focus and calm down and then are put on dangerous psychotropic drugs. Working with my team, we set out to find the best formula with the highest quality ingredients that children would actually like and take. We worked with the leading manufacturer in nutritional supplements that are safe for children to bring you the most affordable and powerful calming formula out there. Introducing Child Ease with herbs and calming extracts like chamomile and lemon balm and essential nutrients that taste great. Obtain your Child Ease today at InfoWarsLife.com. That's Child Ease exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. Knockout is back. If you want a product that has 10 known ingredients that naturally get your body to relax, your brain to relax, so you get deep, restful sleep, knockouts it, InfoWarsLife.com. L-theanine, hops flower extract, lemon balm extract, valerian root extract, chamomile flower extract, L-tryptophan extract, melatonin, and more. All organic, all the natural sources. It's the same price as leading brands of melatonin that are 3 milligrams a piece. It has 3 milligram, the standard recommended dose for an adult. It's got the GABA. So it would probably cost $50 to take all this as separate pills. It's $19.95. You take one or two of these, and it just is really clean, restful sleep is what the reviews are. It's what I've experienced. And it just synergistically puts everything in there. InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com. Or call 888-253-3139.
We began our news with the very sad story of the shooting up in Oregon. And while these things do happen, I think that is a case in favor of something called campus carry. That's where if you're a student, you're 21 years of age, and you may have to undergo some type of training or a permit situation in your state, but basically you'd be able to carry a firearm on your person on the campus. Now, many people are against this, very passionately so, but it's gone from the point of just banning firearms on campuses to now where when Joe Biggs, Kit Daniels, and the rest of the InfoWars crew went out to the University of Texas today, they were even banning people's free speech. So not only could you not have a firearm, but you couldn't even hold a sign that said, hey, I'm pro-gun, or respect my Second Amendment rights, or, you know, whatever the case may be, if you did not have a permit, which is to say that a public university requires you to have a permit to demonstrate in the United States of America. Not only can you not have a Second Amendment, but you also cannot have a First Amendment. And the reason why I'm a supporter of things like campus carry is because you have rapists, you have school shooters, and this isn't any knock on the police, but police cannot be there at all times to protect you. And people will make the argument, well, if something happens, I call the police. Well, that's right. You call a fire department. You call the fire department if your house is on fire. You call the ambulance if you're about to bleed out. You call the police officer if somebody breaks into your house at 3 a.m. because they have what? A gun. You call the fire department because they have a water hose. You call the ambulance because they have the proper equipment to keep you from bleeding out. So yes, there is a need for a firearm in this day and age. And like we've seen multiple times before, despite the police's best efforts, they don't always know exactly what to do. Case in point, the Empire State shooting. A gentleman, well, I shouldn't call him a gentleman, but a man decided to go about a spree of a sort. The police officers pull out their guns. They shoot at the guy. They hit 9 people that are not their intended target. It's somewhat like that scene from Pulp Fiction. Now, once again, there are some police officers who are very well trained, who can react very confidently under a high pressure situation, but those guys were not it. That's why I am an advocate for campus carry. So with that in mind, the crew went out today and tried to have a dialogue with the anti-gun group. And I believe Big said one person was willing to talk to him. Most of them just had ad hominem attacks, called them gun nuts and all this stuff. Didn't want to talk about any factual information out of a source such as the FBI. Not saying I agree with everything the FBI does, but I think their gun numbers and violence numbers are pretty accurate. So this is pretty much the fruit of their labors. They went out there, they tried to speak to people, nobody wanted to talk to them. So they just took it upon themselves to talk about real facts and information that you're not going to hear on other news sources. They just want you to be shaking in fear and waiting for somebody to come and save you. Here's an exchange earlier today.
Joe Biggs here with Infowars.com. Now, the gun-free UT rally just ended, as you can see, starting to, the crowd's about to dissipate. Everyone's starting to move out. Today has been pretty interesting. You've got a lot of speakers, Moms and Men in Action, standing up on the stage over here to my right, who are sitting here calling for free speech, the ability to open a dialogue. Meanwhile, there were two people who were protesting that said they were pro-Second Amendment, who were taken away and arrested just for holding signs.
You're not leaving and you're going to go
for it. Am I doing
something? Yes.
Yes,
for
your student ID.
Hey, good afternoon.
And
you are not an authority.
I am an authority.
She's the dean of students.
I'm the dean of students here at UT.
She's the authority for removing me for what reason?
This is reserved space. You can reserve it tomorrow.
You are free to be anywhere in this West Mall except up here.
I'll come down.
We will ask you to leave. If you do not leave,
they immediately grabbed me and arrested me. I did not consent to searches. I do not consent to seizures. This is public property.
Then a professor got up who was a feminist and said that she is not open for debate, but she's open to hear people's opinions, but she doesn't want to debate anything. You know, I had the ability to try and talk to all these gun-free UT students, faculty, whoever was out here with a t-shirt on, random homeless people they found to put a t-shirt on, they paid off. No one would even have a debate because no one has any facts to support why they are here.
Are you guys on open to discussion? UT gun-free campus?
I am not speaking to you.
Oh, you're not up for debate? Just rather arrest people who have the freedom of speech.
Go home and learn some manners. Some good manners. Your mother would be ashamed.
No, my mother would be super proud. She is proud. That's why I joined the military, Roger, to protect your ability to be able to come out and do this crap. Am I talking
Utah,
real quick?
Somewhere between the rate has fluctuated from 6.6% to 14%.
Anti everybody, are afraid to do anything.
Yeah.
So you can talk to
people want to take your freedoms away, and they won't even debate or talk.
People have mental health issues where we're all super stressed. I don't think that it's necessary to have guns in those classrooms in such like.
Well, how uncomfortable would you feel if a shooter comes to your classroom and you're sitting there like, oh my God, I have this wooden desk?
Well, I would hope that there are, you know, security, campus security.
I don't know if you've
guns,
ever seen any of these shootings that go on, but usually it takes a few minutes and by then there's a body count.
Okay.
You don't want anyone in there to have the ability to be able to maybe take that guy out?
I mean, if that was, I would rather a security handle it, if that's the case.
Campus security?
Yes.
They're not highly trained.
Or cops. I'd rather we go into a lockdown situation.
Why
we
cops
handle
only? Because you think cops are highly trained?
You know, I don't know the statistics on it, but
well,
I know
I'm just in your personal opinion. Do you think cops are highly trained to be able to handle that?
I think cops are trained. Like,
what about the cop who killed Sam DeBose for not having a license plate?
I don't know
what about the cops who killed Kelly Thompson? Well, no, I'm interviewing her. How about you stay over there?
This isn't really interviewing me. You're more just like badgering me, and I'd appreciate it if you got out of my face.
Oh, now she says something.
I'd rather you just get out of my face.
That'd be good. Thank you. It's my freedom to be here.
All right. It's my freedom to say go
right
away
on.
From me.
I'm going to stay here.
All right. Nice to see you.
Guns.
All right. Well, I'll let you say why you're here, and I won't say anything, okay? All right. So tell me why you're here today.
I'm heavily against campus carry. I feel uncomfortable with the idea of students having guns. I don't think arming more people prevents violence. The rape statistic really hit close to home for me. I just don't think it's moving in the right direction.
So do you think only police officers should be armed?
I don't like speaking like in this kind of sense much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Meanwhile, the people who are for campus carry have a wealth of knowledge and know why they're here and have facts to back it up.
Look, with a concealed handgun license, you can carry everywhere else in the state of Texas. I can carry it in malls. I can carry the grocery store, movie theaters. I can carry in the bank. There's no reason why I should not be able to carry inside of a building of a college campus. So all of a sudden, a person that gets a concealed handgun license, they're just not going to go crazy when they cross the threshold of a college campus.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, and the most people here are going to be 18 to 20 years old. So you're not going to have a lot of people anyways. You got to be 21 to have a CHL. So everyone thinks everyone's going to be running and gunning, and it's just going to be this huge, like, okay, corral fight or something.
Right. And I like how they close their little ceremony here by saying that, you know, we had an awesome gun-free event. Well, that's not true at all, because I'm carrying two guns on me right now. So, and I'm standing on the street, sidewalk, walkway, parking lot, or garage of this campus. It's totally legal with a concealed handgun license to carry a gun.
Now, did you try to open any dialogue, debate with any of these anti-gun UT people?
I didn't personally, although I hear that they did try and shut down individuals that did.
Yeah. What about you?
I'm just here. I was studying out in the FAC, and I just decided to come over and support them because it's something that I really believe in, and I've actually been a victim of a lot of crimes, and having a gun in that position is really useful and effective.
Yes, so I was actually watching this back at the studio. You know, guys know I'm doing the nightly news tonight, so I had a lot of work to do back there. But I saw AJ and some of the other guys get arrested for holding a sign. It wasn't even a firearm issue. It wasn't, you know, open carry, anything like that, which has a lot of controversy in these parts. But it was just somebody holding a sign in the United States of America without a permit, which just goes to show, which should alarm anybody who's watching this, that if you may go to an event on your college campus, it may not have anything to do with gun rights. But if you just show up in the wrong place with the right sign, and then they say, oh, no, you can't be here, you're going to get arrested for holding this, that is exceptionally troubling and downright frightening that that would happen in the United States of America. So that's really what brought me out here more than anything else, just to see not just how the Second Amendment, but also the First Amendment is under attack as well. And people are so glad to have you arrested, have you carted off. I saw, you know, ladies, you know, clapping as these guys were shoved into the back of these police cruisers. And understand, ladies, that they weren't arrested for their gun rights. They were arrested for their free speech. So when you clap these guys getting arrested for their free speech, it's just a matter of time before it gets around to you.
You've seen that the anti-gun protesters want nothing to do with having a conversation, not even willing to open a dialogue, just push their rhetoric down your throat and make you listen. But the pro-gun people were willing to have a dialogue because they had facts. And that's what's going on here at UT.
Show your disapproval for Hillary Clinton. Get your Hillary for Prison 2016 t-shirt today at the InfoWars store. Hurry up, because these things are selling out faster than Hillary Clinton.
This is an American president. Just add puppet, then vote and repeat every 4 years.
Introducing Secret 12, the new InfoWars Life vitamin B12 formulation. Now, InfoWarsLife.com is excited to announce that we can bring you our most bioactive, powerful form of B12 that has been developed with our exclusive perfected process. Secret 12 is a binary of nutraceutical-grade, bioavailable coenzyme forms of B12. Secure your revolutionary Secret 12 formula right now at InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139.
I'm running for president. Everyday Americans need a champion, and I want to be that champion. I'm hitting the road to earn your vote, and I hope you'll join me on this journey.
Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
Tim Donnelly is a politician. He is a Republican member of the California State Assembly in 2010. He was reelected in 2012. Donnelly was also a candidate for the California governor in 2014. He placed third in that open primary. He's also a radio talk show host on Radio Free California, and it's the TimDonnellyShow.com. So welcome, Mr. Donnelly, to the show. Now, what's going on with SB 277? I know that there was a massive push to get some signatures to oppose this bill.
Yes, that is correct, and thank you for having me on. We've been working tirelessly. When I say we, myself and thousands of Californians who are concerned about this egregious assault on not just parents' rights, but natural rights, human rights, the right to decide what you inject in your own body or your child's body. And in that time frame, we have educated an incredible number of people and created a grassroots movement that is hitting full stride now. The signature gathering is over. The signatures have been turned into the registrar of voters in all of the 58 counties in California, and we are waiting for their final tally on them.
Okay, so the final tally hasn't come in. I know that there was a little bit of discrepancy there. The LA Times was reporting that it's over, it's done, there weren't enough votes. Some people are saying, you know, was there a little bit of sabotage involved? Thousands of signatures are missing. So there's a little bit of a discrepancy there with these votes. And as well, I know you talked about facing some strong opposition from the pharmaceutical lobby as well.
Well, we certainly have seen a tremendous amount of opposition, and we've even experienced it undermining within the movement itself, individuals who purported to be in favor of our viewpoint, wound up undermining much of what we were doing. And I've never really seen it this strong. And I think it has to do with the amount of money that's involved. You're talking hundreds of billions of dollars when it comes to the pharmaceutical industry, at least in the United States.
Right. Yeah, and we have actually seen a lot of the pharmaceutical lobby there behind some of the people responsible for getting SB 277 passed. So obviously a lot of money propping those sort of people up as well. Now, I know you're saying that your voices have been heard and you're not going anywhere. So what can people do from here if there aren't enough votes at this point?
Well, if there's not enough signatures, then obviously it won't qualify for the ballot. And, and that'll be a massive disappointment to all of those who were hopeful that it would ultimately qualify. But look, the fight doesn't end. The next step would naturally be lawsuits, because when you look at what SB 277 does, it actually holds your child's educational future hostage. It kicks your child out of every public setting for education, be it public school, private school, charter schools, or even daycare. And in some homeschooling environment where the homeschoolers association has a relationship with the public school to come in with a charter school to come in and do some sort of a public activity that involves hanging around with other kids, your kid would be ostracized and forbidden to attend that. And what's their crime? Maybe missing one single booster shot. That's literally what we're doing here. And the government is forcing, coercing, and intimidating parents into going against their own personal beliefs or religious beliefs or their conscience. And they're doing it in the name of a health crisis that doesn't exist.
Right. Well, I mean, they're basically saying that their vaccinated children are getting sick by unvaccinated children, which then, well, why are you even getting vaccines if they're clearly not working? Their whole argument doesn't even make sense. So what are go ahead.
When you start to ask people questions like that, they get really mad.
They do.
It's kind of funny. So you take the CDC's own report on the so-called measles outbreak at Disneyland. The CDC claims that they wiped out measles back in 2000 or 2003. There hasn't been a death since 2003. And yet this little measles outbreak at Disneyland, which happened in 2014, was used as an excuse to target and scapegoat those who have chosen to either not vaccinate or selectively vaccinate their children. And they represent a very, very small part of the population. They tend to be much more knowledgeable about their health and health care issues in general. And what's fascinating is when you read the CDC's website, they've identified the original patient as most likely being a foreign visitor to the U.S. So someone came here and reintroduced measles in the United States, and they've gone after a completely different group of people, even though when you look at the rest of the results and the information on their website, people who were vaccinated and people who were not vaccinated and people whose vaccination status were unknown contracted and spread the disease equally.
Right. And something I did a report on this, I guess I forget the young guy's name that they were kind of parading around, and he was sort of the poster child for this SB277. He was getting chemo treatments and basically saying, don't bring your unvaccinated kid to school and make someone like me that's, you know, has a failing immune system susceptible to those viruses. When if you go to the Johns Hopkins site or another one of these children's hospitals, it specifically used to say, right before they were trying to pass SB 277, to avoid contact with the recently vaccinated, that it was those recently vaccinated children that were actually going to be the more dangerous ones that could possibly pass along a virus. And they changed that manual that they would give to people receiving cancer treatment to fit this ideology here with SB 277, which
that doesn't surprise me.
I mean, that was fascinating.
When the powers that be decide they want to push a narrative, when they have the media compliant, and they have terrified the media into not reporting on anything to do with vaccine side effects.
Right.
So the buzzword is safe and effective, even though the Supreme Court has said that they're unavoidably unsafe. And the Vaccine Injury Compensation Fund that is actually run by the government, funded by your tax dollars and my tax dollars, has paid out over $3 billion in injuries for a product that's supposed to be safe and effective. So obviously something's wrong. And when you start to ask questions, it's funny. People who don't trust the government on anything else, all of a sudden, with the sacred cow of vaccinations, they become mind-numb zombies, and it's like, oh, the government knows all. The government is, we must trust the government. We must protect public health.
Right.
When in fact, the government has been found recently to have been burying and shredding and destroying evidence of causal links between the mercury-based preservative thimerosal and autism-like side effects. And yet the media just blacks it out and ignores it.
Right.
And that right there is a much greater threat to our health than any of these diseases.
Yeah, absolutely. And you're not allowed to think anything other than what science tells us, even though we've got reports where they're admittedly using junk science to prop up these huge corporations, like Coca-Cola, for instance, was just found to be bought and paid for scientists who would find the results that would favor their company. What's going on there in California? I mean, they are really occupied territory. I guess in 2013, Adon, our writer, said he first became aware of you after that case where a child was abducted by CPS after the parents dared to seek a second opinion. The parents were there in the hospital and they were concerned with the care they were receiving for their child after a nurse failed to properly address why the child was being given antibiotics. So the parents wanted to maybe go get a second opinion, and CPS snatched them from their home. So, I mean,
yeah. Well, it was fascinating because the mother, the only thing she was guilty of is loving her child too much. She had a mother's instinct that she was going to be handed back a dead baby because they wanted to do open heart surgery on him today.
I began to get into iodine a few years ago because it was helping me and my family so much get healthy and detoxify. I believe our research is conclusive. This is the best iodine out there. And I know this for a fact. Nobody else has got iodine based on these pure crystals, ladies and gentlemen.
For a limited time, experience the ancient power of Survival Shield X2.
I believe our research is conclusive. This is the best iodine out there.
Take advantage of this at InfoWarsLife.com.
And why wearing a Hillary for President t-shirt might get you punched in the face.
They thought it said Hillary for President. He said, I was seconds away from sending my bar back over here to punch you in the face. Since you're wearing a Hillary for Prison shirt, you don't have to buy drinks here. Everything's on the house.
Hillary's not surging, I tell you that. They're not saying that. They're not saying that. Thank you.
There you have it. Donald Trump endorses Hillary for Prison. Get your Hillary for Prison 2016 t-shirt at the InfoWars store. And on the back, it says, legalize freedom. Show your disapproval of Hillary by buying your t-shirt today.
But what she's done is criminal.
This is an American president. Just add puppet, then vote and repeat every 4 years.
Another threat that President Obama mentioned was ISIS. Well, who on earth armed them? Who helped to arm the Syrians that were fighting against Assad? Who created the necessary political climate that facilitated this situation? Who pushed for the delivery of arms to the area? Do you really not understand as to who is fighting in Syria?
Vladimir Putin and his Russian military have opened up a can of worms in Syria. The mouthpiece of a world propaganda war is spouting a din of disinformation, the likes of which the United States has never seen before. Where does the media's loyalty lie? The litmus test is on newsstands, TVs, and radios right now. Current Secretary of Defense Ash Carter drew the first line in the sand, claiming
it does appear that they were in areas where there probably were not ISIL forces, and that is precisely one of the problems with this whole approach.
The governor on the propaganda engine cruising down America's freedom of the press highway was removed 2 years ago. The Smith-Mundt Modernization Act of 2012 was quietly shoehorned into the 2013 National Defense Authorization Act. This act nullified the Smith-Mundt Act of 1948, amended in 1985, an act specifically prohibiting the influence of the U.S. government in regards to public opinion in the United States.
It was Bashar Assad that gave birth to ISIL.
John McCain is firing the first shots.
The fact is that we are now seeing an unleashing of Russian air power to take out the Free Syrian Army. And that is disgraceful, but I might do what we did in Afghanistan many years ago to give those guys the ability to shoot down those planes, just like the Afghans shot down Russian planes after Russia invaded Afghanistan.
McCain is referring to how the United States armed Islamic militants in the 1970s, a policy that led to the rise of the Taliban, Al-Qaeda, the Muslim Brotherhood, and Osama bin Laden. Senator McCain is opposed to Russia's bombing of ISIS terrorists because he believes that Moscow is using this explanation as a cover to attack U.S.-backed Syrian rebel forces who are trying to topple Bashar al-Assad. And while the American public attempts to wrap its mind around the fact that Obama and Kerry are pitching a fit, that Putin is blatantly throwing a monkey wrench into the globalist plans.
And the only way the United States can have any effect in this region and turn the tide is to start killing Russians by killing so many Russians that even Putin's media can't hide the fact that Russians are returning to the motherland in body bags.
The Russians are firing back, not only in Syria, but in the information war. The BBC reports the Russian Defense Ministry said the Russian jets carried out 20 raids on Wednesday, 12 of them against IS targets. It insisted that no civilian infrastructure was targeted. Four of the air raids against IS were conducted at night. In all, Russia has deployed more than 50 planes and helicopters to Syria, the Russian Defense Ministry says. The Russians are even documenting the raids with drones. Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov is firing back as well.
In accordance with Article 51 of the Charter, I haven't heard of any preventive self-defense concept. No proof, no nothing. Legal basis of the coalition activities in Syria is really flawed.
The rest of planet Earth has had enough of Obama's shady CIA operation. There is a war on for your mind, and the great lie is the invisible weaponry of the ruling elite.
Another fantastic report there from John Baum. Now, we began our show tonight talking about the shooting in Oregon, and out of respect for those victims and the families who are suffering, I wanted to change my comments remove my comments about President Barack Obama's speech from that so I can just focus on Barack Obama's speech. Here is a brief snippet of that.
It cannot be this easy for somebody who wants to inflict harm on other people to get his or her hands on a gun. And what's become routine, of course, is the response of those who oppose any kind of common sense gun legislation. We need more guns, they'll argue. Fewer gun safety laws. Does anybody really believe that? There are scores of responsible gun owners in this country. They know that's not true.
Now, like I said, that's just a snippet. He has a very long speech. But I'm just going to address some of the things that our president has said about this most recent tragedy. First of all, I don't think he gets any pleasure from seeing these tragedies, so don't, put that in the YouTube comments or whatever. But to talk specifically about some of the things he said states that have some of the toughest gun laws have the fewest gun victims. Well, let's just kind of compare and contrast this. I'm going off the top of my head right now. I'm freestyling this. When we talk about the city of Chicago, we have 4th of July weekends, other type of weekends going back for the past several years. We see dozens upon dozens of people shot, if not murdered, in his city of Chicago, Chicago that has some of the toughest gun laws in the United States of America. But by and large, the gangbangers, the drug dealers, the people out there on the street corners, just didn't get the memo that they were supposed to turn in their firearms. So this notion that if you have stricter gun laws, you will have less gun victims is completely bunk. Now, of course, you do have many law-abiding gun citizens, whether they are in the city of Chicago, any place else in the United States. They have a gun, they have a concealed carry, they have a shotgun in the closet, whatever. They don't harm anybody. They just have it there for their self-defense, or they have it there for their recreation, their hunting, their fishing, whatever else they may be doing with it. Now, to talk more about some of the comments President Obama made, talking about we're the only advanced nation that has this, that, X, Y, Z happen, let's talk about some of the things that he's doing. He mentioned, or he often mentions, places like Britain, other places, Australia, that have very strict gun laws. And yes, they do have fewer gun-related deaths, but also they have other types of other violent crimes, such as in Great Britain, they have a large amount of muggings. They have a large amount of home invasions. And let's shift from talking about Britain to talking about Mexico, because we know in Mexico, they have very strict gun laws as well, but the cartels also didn't get the memo that they're supposed to hand in their firearms. So out there killing people, they're hanging journalists from the rafters. Every day you see a cartel shooting. They came in and killed a whole town, killing police chiefs, mayors, everything down there. So you go a step further and you realize that this administration who's trying to lecture you about your gun rights here in the United States of America has actually given firearms to the Sinaloa drug cartel down in Mexico under Operation Fast and Furious that has killed Lord knows how many people, including a Border Patrol agent, Brian Terry. But he doesn't want to talk about that. He'll do this. I think one person got in trouble. Who was it? The assistant AG, Lanny Brewer. I don't even think Holder was touched on that, even though it's hard for me to believe it. Holder didn't at least know about it. But, you know, that's a story for another time. He's, you know, gone off to pasture, so to speak. But President Obama will get on a plane, go to Mexico, and say that the reason that Mexico has such high gun violence is because of gun demands here in the United States of America. When coming full circle, his administration was providing guns, fully operational guns at that, to Mexican drug cartels. And you want to tell me about a background check? You knew who the people you were who were giving the guns to. You already did your background checks, and then you found the worst people possible to give those firearms to. Let's go overseas now. Let's talk about ISIS. ISIS, you know, which we've already documented, they have the Humvees, all the other toys and shenanigans going on over there. But we've seen the video. We've shown it 1,000 times here. The airdrop grenades of the ISIS collecting these grenades that are airdropped on the ground. They said, oops, we accidentally sent this to the wrong people. Well, I think even if that is true, which I don't believe, even if that is true, if you're going to drop that much ordnance, you damn sure better make sure you're dropping it in the right spot. And I don't think it's incompetence on behalf of the pilots or anybody else. I think they were told to drop it there for a reason. But, you know, you can call me a conspiracy theorist, even though we see ISIS going out there chopping people's heads off and all the other things that we talk about quite frequently. Also, there's an excellent report. I think in the 3 years I've been here at InfoWars, this is the best report we have ever done. It's called Obama Orders Children Murdered. It's produced by our nightly news producer, Rob Duke. And in this was back after we had the tragedy at Sandy Hook. Obama comes out there, he gives a normal speech just like you heard here today. He's saying we have to do something about all this gun violence. Meanwhile, we have all these people dying from drone strikes in these foreign countries, but he doesn't want to talk about any of that. He doesn't want to talk about the wedding that became a funeral. You can go Google that article and take a look at it for yourself. He doesn't want to talk about the kids get their jaws blown off, faces blown off, all these horrific things. Because of his drone policy, they'll knock down an entire apartment building to kill two terrorists and kill 50 other people. Oops, that's the cost of doing business. So don't sit up there and lecture me about my gun rights and how I have to go through this background check and jump through all these hoops when you are doing things that are killing people, not just in this country, but all around the world with your policies and the policies of your predecessors. It's completely disgusting. I'm tired of hearing about all this crap. And to end on just a completely different note, I was in Washington, D.C. last week. I saw homeless people sleeping in front of the White House. So don't tell me that we need to bring everybody in from all of these other countries when you won't take care of people who are living in your own damn front yard. That's it for the InfoWars Nightly News. I'm your host, Jakari Jackson. We will see you again tomorrow night.
Knockout is back. If you want a product that has 10 known ingredients that naturally get your body to relax, your brain to relax, so you get deep, restful sleep, Knockout's it. InfoWarsLife.com. L-theanine, hops flower extract, lemon balm extract, valerian root extract, chamomile flower extract, L-tryptophan extract, melatonin, and more. All organic, all the natural sources. It's the same price as leading brands of melatonin that are 3 milligrams a piece. It has 3 milligrams, the standard recommended dose for an adult. It's got the GABA, so it would probably cost $50 to take all this as separate pills. It's $19.95. You take one or two of these, and it just is really clean, restful sleep is what the reviews are. It's what I've experienced, and it just synergistically puts everything in there. InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com, or call 888-253-3139.
You are watching the InfoWars Nightly News, which airs 7 p.m. Central at InfoWarsNews.com, and your support is helping us defend liberty worldwide.